So thank you, welcome to the last talk for this evening. My name is Irene Bighelli, I'm a psychologist and psychotherapist, and I work at the Technical University of Munich in the Department of Psychiatry and Psychotherapy. As a researcher, as Liliana said, I am interested in evaluating the efficacy of different psychotherapies in mental health. But tonight, I will tell you about the framework, so the background on which my work takes place. So, we all know the situation in which we have a medical problem. And I'm pretty sure that nowadays, that is something that most of us is very likely to do. And it is to Google our problem. Yes. That's good on our side, because in that way we can have access to a lot of information about our symptoms, or what our problem can be, and also about how it can be treated. But on the other side, this is also not so good, because not all of this information is reliable. And so this search can also bring to strange results, and it's not straightforward that this search will help us. But a question might come to our mind, so one can ask himself, do I really need a doctor then? Could I just look online, all alone, by myself? And then why would I need a doctor? So during the next 15 minutes, my aim is to answer this question. How is a clinical decision taken? So, when we have a health problem, how is the decision taken about how to manage it? And we will discuss about the role of patients, doctors, and science during this process. Well, let's imagine that we have a friend, Jane, and Jane has received this diagnosis. So, Jane has schizophrenia. Schizophrenia is a mental health problem, it's an illness, and it's actually a very burdensome illness. So people, Jane was hearing voices in her head, was convinced about things that are not real, and she was feeling very bad for this reason, and she was avoiding social contact, she was even at risk of losing her job. So finally, with the help of her family, she looked for professional help, and she will have now an appointment with a doctor. So what will happen during this appointment? Who and how will decide what to do for Jane's problem? Jane's problem is a medical problem, and it has to be managed. And the decision about how to manage this problem is a clinical decision. So for schizophrenia, there are different possibilities, so different treatments are available. Most of the times, pharmacological treatment is necessary, and there are different medicines available that are called antipsychotics. They are more or less working, all of them are working, but they can present different side effects, so unwanted effects of the medication. For example, some of them could bring to movement problems, or to sexual problems, or to weight gain. So they are quite different from this point of view. Other treatments that are available for this condition are talking therapies, so psychotherapy, or also called psychological treatments, and also here there are different ones that are available. But who is going to decide what to do between these different options? First of all, what is the role of the patient in this process? So there are different possibilities. One person could say, I want to decide about my treatment, so it's my health, it's my decision, I want to make this decision alone. Or at the other extreme, one person could say, I will just do what the doctor says. It's the job of the doctor to decide about the best treatment, and I will just do what they tell me to do. Or one person could say, well, I want to discuss with my doctor, and we together can take a decision. I would be very interested to know what is your opinion about it, so I will ask you now to raise your hands First of all, who would like to decide on his own? Please, raise your hands. Okay. Thanks. Who would like to leave the decision to the doctor? Okay. Who would like to decide together with the doctor? Oh, thanks. Okay. So, most of you is preferring this third option. And this third option is called shared decision making. So shared decision making is a model that describes how doctor and patients can interact with each other in order to take a good decision for the patient. And the idea behind it is that both doctor and patient have important roles in this process. And when we study this model, we see that actually it works. So when it is applied, it brings to better relation between doctor and patient. It brings to better satisfaction from both sides. It brings to minor cost for the health system, and also to higher adherence to the treatment. What does it mean? When the patient is involved in deciding about the treatment plan, then he's more committed, he's more motivated to follow the treatment plan. And all in all, these things all together, they bring to better results for the health of the person. So this model actually allows to consider three very important aspects. And now we will go through them one by one. First of all, our Jane is now at the appointment with the doctor and she has some important things in her mind that she tells. So, first of all, she does not want to have this problem anymore. So these voices were disturbing, these symptoms were bad for her, and she, of course, wants to solve this problem. But since she looked online, like all of us, she discovered that this medication can cause sometimes weight gain, and this is something she's concerned about. She would like to avoid it. And so she tells this also to the doctor. And then Jane would like to understand more about her illness, to understand what is happening to her, and have also more information about her experience, and share her experience with people who have the same problem. And all together with these aspects, we can call the patient's wishes. So how do we know what medication is working, what are the side effects, what are the possible treatments, how is this knowledge created? To create this knowledge is the role of science. In the medical field, this information, this knowledge, is created by clinical studies. So when we have a topic, we have an illness, a clinical study works like that. We will take a group of people with this illness and we will split them into two groups. One group will take one treatment and the other group will take the other treatment. So very roughly speaking, in the end, if we see that, for example, 54% of the patients are feeling better with the first treatment and only 41 of the patients are feeling better with the second treatment, okay, we can say the first treatment is better. There is a lot of statistics here in the middle, but this is the idea how it works. However, one study is not enough to produce reliable, sufficient knowledge on a topic. That's why usually many studies are conducted on the same topic. And at this point, who is going to read all this stuff? So doctors have a lot to do, they have a lot of work with their patients, and people who don't have these skills maybe don't understand what is written in these complicated studies. So we have a problem here. And that's why some researchers, and that's also what I do, collect all the studies that were done on the single topic, on the same topic, and we put them together and we make like a big summary that provides an overall picture of the knowledge about this topic. And these are called systematic reviews. These systematic reviews can then be further used to produce clinical guidelines. Guidelines are like instructions, recommendations that the doctor can use every day in their practice, in their work with the patients. And all this path, all the knowledge that comes from this path, we can call the evidence. So what is the role of the doctor then? In the past, there was this idea that the doctor is an expert, so that thanks to his big experience, he can decide everything. Nowadays, the experience of the doctor is of course always important, but we have this idea that it must be combined with this evidence. So the paradigm that is used nowadays is called evidence-based medicine. So medicine is based on evidence and also on experience of the doctor. They must be combined in order to be meaningful. So the doctor is also now at the meeting with our friend Jane. And based on this evidence and on his experience, he tells her, for example, that there are different medicines that are available, that they are efficacious, but they can produce this or that side effect. And also that there are groups of patients that are meeting and they can share their experience and maybe talk without psychologists. And this also is organized, is available. This was the second important aspect to consider, but it's not finished. Because in our case, Jane has also another illness. She has also diabetes, unfortunately. And so for this reason, she cannot take some medications. So the decision will have to consider this point. And moreover, Jane is far from the hospital. She does not drive the car. And so for her, it would be unrealistic to plan a treatment program in which she has to drive every day to the hospital. And these aspects play also a fundamental role in the decision, and we can call them the patient circumstances. So in the end, only considering all three of these domains, it will be possible to make a meaningful decision. If we don't consider one of them, something will not work. And to summarize, what I would like you to remember is on this slide. So the role of science in this process is to provide information that we can call evidence on a specific treatment for a specific illness. The role of the doctor is to analyze this information and also based on his experience, discuss these options with the patients. So tell, for example, what are the benefits or what are the harms connected with each treatment possibility. And the role of the patient from his side is to bring to the doctor to express his or her needs, his preferences, what is important for him or for her, to get the correct information and be proactive in this decision. So in case you have any sort of medical problem, I strongly encourage you to look for this process. So ask a lot of questions to your doctor, take a lot of good information and be active in the decision that concerns your health. Thanks to this process, the patient and the doctor together, they can discuss and they can take a meaningful and good decision that is hopefully the best for that patient in his situation and with his specific needs. So here I provide you some links. They are reliable sources of information and they provide information about the evidence that is available for the treatments in different medical problems. If you are interested about my research, you can have a look at this website. And my research was actually, as we said before, about the psychological treatments for schizophrenia. So thank you very much for your attention, and please ask any questions.